In this lab, you will be determining the composition of a mixture of benzoic acid and 4-aminoacetophenone using a separation technique by separatory funnel. Before you start, make sure to wear goggles, your mask, and gloves. Hi everyone, welcome to your lab on acid-base extraction. First, we will need to weigh out about 3 grams of the unknown mixture of benzoic acid and 4-aminoacetophenone. Then, measure out about 10 milliliters of ethyl acetate using a graduated cylinder. Pour the ethyl acetate and solid into an Erlenmeyer flask and dissolve. Pour the solution into a separatory funnel equipped with a ring stand and ring clamp. Rinse the Erlenmeyer flask with 2 milliliters of ethyl acetate 3 times and pour into the separatory funnel. You are now ready for your first extraction. For the first extraction, we will be extracting 4-aminoacetophenone from the ethyl acetate solution by reacting it with 1 molar hydrochloric acid to form its salt, 4-aminoacetophenone hydrochloride. This will allow the salt to be extracted in the aqueous layer. Then, we will return the salt to its original form using 3 molar sodium hydroxide. Make sure you have an Erlenmeyer flask beneath the separatory funnel to receive the aqueous layer before you start. Measure 10 milliliters of 1 molar hydrochloric acid and pour into the separatory funnel. Replace the glass stopper on top of the funnel and gently shake it like so. Tilt the funnel up and slowly open the valve to release pressure. You should hear a subtle gush of air. Close the valve back up and allow the 2 layers to completely separate. The bottom layer is the aqueous layer that contains the salt, 4-aminoacetophenone hydrochloride. The top layer is the organic layer. Now, remove the glass stopper and slowly open the valve to extract the aqueous layer into the receiving Erlenmeyer flask. Close the valve once the line separating the 2 layers reaches the valve. Repeat this process 2 more times with fresh 10 milliliter portions of 1 molar hydrochloric acid into the same receiving Erlenmeyer flask. Using a small piece of pH paper, determine the pH of the combined aqueous extracts. Add 3 molar sodium hydroxide to the solution until it is just basic. This will be indicated by the pH paper. Once basic, add an additional 5 milliliters of 3 molar sodium hydroxide. This will allow the 4-aminoacetophenone hydrochloride to return to its original form, 4-aminoacetophenone, which you will see as precipitate. For the second part of this experiment, we need to extract the benzoic acid from the ethyl acetate solution that is still in the separatory funnel. This will be done by reacting benzoic acid with 1 molar sodium hydroxide. This will allow benzoic acid to be extracted in the aqueous layer as a salt. Then, we will return the salt to its original form using 3 molar hydrochloric acid. This extraction will use the same process as the previous extraction. You will be adding a 10 milliliter portion of 1 molar sodium hydroxide to the separatory funnel. You will use 3 molar hydrochloric acid until the solution becomes just acidic, then adding an additional 5 milliliters of 3 molar hydrochloric acid. You will be able to see the precipitate form. Now, you will collect the precipitate from each extraction using vacuum filtration. You will need a fresh Erlenmeyer flask, a ring stand, a rubber hose, and a filtration funnel equipped with filter paper and a rubber stopper for each precipitate. Turn the vacuum on, wash the filter paper with water, and carefully transfer the precipitates into their respective funnels. Wash the Erlenmeyer flasks with small portions of distilled water to transfer all of the precipitate. Then allow the precipitate to completely dry. And that's the end. Thank you for watching, and now you understand acid-base extraction.